You may not recognize our new name, but I'm sure you'll all be familiar with our founding chief. She's well known, I know, to Sir Charles and Geoffrey. The JCAWLC, as we were originally called, the Jenny Craig Airline and Weight Loss Company. We started from relatively small beginnings. I was invited along on the inaugural flight. I remember it distinctly because the check-in desk was in Jenny Craig's front living room, and we had to take our bags up to the bathroom for the weigh-in procedures. We drove out in a Volkswagen minibus to the airport. It was quite an auspicious occasion. Jenny, in fact, was one of the first people to come up with the concept of weighing the passengers instead of the baggage. And that, we believe, is going to become the trend. Her unique ticketing and fare structure is currently being studied by international airlines around the world, and in particular by Ansett, I know. All of Jenny Craig's fares, in case you weren't aware of it, are based on her unique your weight times the distance traveled formula. And our experts have calculated that if you can do away with one or two of the essentials in this airline business, really the non-essentials, things like, you know, maintenance and in-flight service and baggage check-in, and we're working on those areas. You can cut fares really to the bone, and that's really what we're all about. And in fact, the bulk of our revenue now comes from our burger bars in flight, and the sale of lost and mislaid luggage. I should point out that our reduced price structure is having a great deal to do with the amazing results that we're producing. Warwick, you might like to take notes of some of these. If you fly on a Tuesday or Wednesday, it's cheaper. If you fly tourist, that's cheaper. If you book 12 months in advance, that's cheaper. If you fly at night, that's cheaper. We've got 50% off for standby. And if you stay on board for the return journey, we'll take a little bit off for that. In actual fact, I flew tourist last Wednesday night, standby, and the airline paid me $14. Like all Jenny Craig's commercials, it's her remarkable ability to come up with truly unique marketing ideas that make her the success that she is today. I think that the horizontal seating arrangement that she introduced is a forerunner, really. In actual fact, we have it on the grapevine that the Fly United stickers that have been sold just won't stand a chance when compared with our new I Got Laid on Jenny Craig. I've been asked to say one or two things about my appointment to Ansett. I spent a number of years with Aer Lingus. I suppose you've all heard about the Irishman that ran reservations and said, how long is the flight from Dublin to London? And the girl said, just a minute, sir. And he said, thanks, you're not. Anybody Irish here? Anybody from Ireland? Okay. I love Ireland. I know nowhere else in the world where you can hear a conversation that goes something like, where were you going when I saw you going to work this morning? When I caught up with you, you were gone. Now, if you understand you're obviously Irish. Well, you'd pick up the telephone and a voice at the other end would say, is that yourself? I'll never forget when I first arrived in Dublin, I thought I'd introduce myself to my next door neighbors. I knocked on the door, a little boy about, I don't know, 6, 7 years of age, answered the door. I said, is Mom and Dad in? He said, no, as a matter of fact, he said, Dad got burnt this morning. I said, my God, I hope it wasn't serious. He said, well, they don't mess around at the crematorium. I guess it's a question of understanding and communication. I just want to say, though, seriously, a few things about my appointment. My appointment for Ansett was actually announced on the eve of my engagement, or rather, I beg your pardon, on the eve of Jeffrey's engagement to my daughter. They've known each other for 2 years now. They met at her 17th birthday party. 2 years ago, they've just come back from a holiday on Hayman, and I was at the airport to meet them when they arrived. I mean, she was a wretch. I mean, she looked like she'd been hit by a truck. I said, what happened? She said, well, she said, you know, all the time we've been courting, Jeffrey's been telling me he's been saving up for 20 years to get married. I thought he meant money.
Entry.
printed across the bottom of the menu, take a look if you don't believe it before you leave, is the statement, in the interests of hygiene, all vegetables in this establishment have been washed in water, passed by the management. I've been asked, incidentally, to also apologize on behalf of John Devoney. John had hoped to have his wife here tonight, but she's taking a job for the weekend. She's helping the milkman. It's only until the horse gets better. But... Actually, my wife is going to be here, but she's in Scotland at the moment. She's got a summer job with the tourist board there. She swims up and down Loch Ness, entertaining the tourists. I should tell you that we at Ansett have been very conscious of the increase in rising costs. Now, this is something which needed to be addressed, and I want to make the point that Warwick Foote has done, Warwick's our national reservations manager, you were aware of that. Warwick is really responsible for some innovative moves, and Warwick, would you stand up? Warwick tells me that as of Monday, we're introducing one or two new charges. Now, there's going to be a 10% charge if you want to end up at the same destination as your baggage. Flight catering is being turned over to McDonald's with effect from Monday. And I must mention this, Jordina. Could you stand up, Jordina, please? Jordine has been responsible for designing our new air hostess uniform, it's really a stunner. I've asked my secretary if she'd be kind enough to model it for you this evening, and she's a little bit bashful. You might like to just give her a round of applause. You might enjoy this. Shui Maurice, ladies and gentlemen. Coin. Would you have a 20-cent piece of... I know it's... it's no good the gentleman slipping her one. Not at this time. Yes, we have... You... Oh. There's only one slight problem. It's not the coin I want to chew. Yes, I bet you would.
Let me just organize this.
What I want you to do, may I ask your name?
Karen.
You don't mind if I call you Karen? Tomorrow? Karen, it's essential that nobody touches your coin. I want you to hold it in the palm of your hand. No, the clean one. And I'll get you to close your eyes. Just keep it in the palm of your hand. I'm going to concentrate on your child. You're going to like this. Just rest it on my left arm.
You're
taught me this. I'm just going to concentrate on it. As I do so, you may feel the coin starting to get warm in your hands. Will you tell me, please, the moment you feel the change? That's unusual. You don't normally get a lot of change out of 20 cents on that. Darling, in just a moment, I'm going to get you to open your fingers. As you do so, you may feel the coin starting to move. Would you gradually just open your hand slowly? Oh, dear. What have you done? Oh, my God. Look at that. It's pants. Listen, I just had a terrible thought. Everything you get hold of doesn't bend like that, does it? Give her a big round of applause. If you put that on the table, I promise you it'll continue to bend right through the end. Like most of our aircraft. We planned another little experiment for you. Gravity is very big in the airline business. there's an awful lot of it about it. And we thought, by way of an experiment tonight, we might... John didn't lose his wallet, did he? They said he kept it on a string. The gravity business is quite interesting, and I'd like to conduct a little experiment. Perhaps a Sylvia. Where's Sylvia?
Sylvia.
Would you mind helping me up just for a moment? I'm sure you would. Give her a big round of applause. Cherie to come back and show us. Let's move this out here just a minute. Would you like to join me, Jenny? We this is rather a question. Harold is delighted to meet you, Harold. Sylvia, have you met Harold?
Cherie's got a chain here. Slightly tangled up. This is very important. This is for everything.
Harold, would you hang on to one end of that, please? Okay. And would you mind hanging on to the other end? Now, Harold, just I'll tell you what we might do. We might just move. Let me just organize. Just so the folks on the cheap seats back here. Would you like to just move back here, Harold? That's lovely. Now, Harold, just to convince everybody that gravity does work, I wonder if you'd mind taking one end of that chain and just passing it through the top of your trousers, and hopefully it should come out the bottom. Would you do that for me, please? Don't worry, if it can't stop, Sylvia will reach up and give it a pull for you.
Stop.
Now, in the meantime, Cherie selected a gentleman there to assist us. We've got a padlock there, sir, and we've got a bunch of keys. Would you mind taking those keys and trying each one in the padlock until you find one that will, in fact, open the lock for me? Oh, that's lovely, yes. That's fine. Now, that's great.
Now it's your turn. would you mind just standing a little closer together? Now, if you just take that in and pass that through the box, gradually down through the box.
Warm it up first. I'm sure it's warm, so we don't know about any cold.
It's cold. Can we answer it all?
If you just hold it out and give her a hand, would you? How are we doing with the keys, sir?
None of them.
You've tried them all? Just pop them in the glass. How are we doing here? Are we just... Yes? There'll be a short intermission. Somewhere in Cherie's dress. If you wouldn't mind just having a quick sort of grope around. Not too much of a diversion, in the lock and see if that works. If it does, okay, leave it wide open, sir, please. Warwick, would you mind dropping the key in with the others and giving them to Cherie, please? And Warwick, if you just bring the lock open, padlock open, open, leave it open, and if you wouldn't mind just locking those two ends together down there.
Is that pronouncing about the watch?
Is it locked? Yes? Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank Warwick very much indeed. Thank you, sir. All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do. A little experiment in ESP. I'm going to ask Cherie, now, bearing in mind that Warwick's proved just that only one of those keys fits the lock, I'm going to ask Cherie to mix them all up. I'm going to tip them into your hand, sir, if you wouldn't mind. Would you just hold your hand up? That's fine. And, so what I'm going to ask you to do is to pick them up one at a time. You, of course, would have no idea, really, which key fits the lock. Is that correct? All right. You put that hand away. Let's slowly pick one at a time. When you get one down, what I want you to do is hold it up in the air. When you've got it in the air, I want you to yell ready, all right? I'm going to turn my back. When you've got the key in the air, yell ready. I'll tell you whether to keep it or to put it in the glass.
My job is to try to find the one key that will, in fact, open the lock. Let's see how it goes. Let me know when you've got that first key.
Ready?
My God, she gets ready quickly, doesn't she? No, not that one. In the glass, please. Pick another one.
Ready?
No, in the glass with that one, thank you.
Ready?
That's the key I want you to hang on to. If there are any other keys left, would you put them in the glass, please? Now, bearing in mind, ladies and gentlemen, that only one key would open the lock, and nobody could have known which key was the right one. Would you like to try that key in the lock? It's your reputation that's at stake. I think you might have to get used to doing things together. You like this? Yes, I bet you do. Oh, damn, what a shame it worked. Snap it shut, he said. You might like just to hand that to Cherie and
And your prize tonight is you've won each other. Have a good evening. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to go. Now, to round off this evening, and you really have been a magnificent audience, and I do thank you for that. It's been an awful lot of fun. We'd like to present something just a little bit different. I visited Perth some 7 years ago, and we took part in a program with Willacy that some of you may or may not recall, depending on how good your memories are. But at that time, as part of a demonstration into the field of extrasensory perception, we invited people with broken watches and clocks at home to bring them along to the television sets in an attempt to try to make them work. And over, I believe over 500 people in the Perth district reported at that time that watches and clocks that hadn't worked for many, many years suddenly started to tick. Now, I don't know whether anyone here tonight has a watch or clock that's not keeping good time, and that's very important in the airline business. But we're going to try and fix them for you in the course of this next little experiment we're going to round off with tonight. My watch says that it's 20 minutes to 10. If your watch doesn't say that, would you indicate? There's a number. All right. Would you mind bringing yours over? And the gentleman beside you, sir, would you mind? Shui, would you like to find a couple over there? Anybody over there whose watch isn't working too well? Just take them off and hold them in your hand, if you will. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Would you bring them over, thanks? If you... Yes? Gentleman over there, fine. That's all. Okay. What about another lady, Shui? Can we find another lady? There must be a lady over here. Is there a lady? Any lady there with a watch that's not keeping good time? Anybody else? No? No more volunteers to keep these gentlemen company? All right. I might ask you to come up front. We'll ignore the microphone. Would you mind just here so I can take a quick look at those? How long, sir, have you had your watch?
24 years.
You don't mind if I call you, sir?
No.
Sir, what is the time by your watch?
The big finger's on, and the little finger's on.
It's what, sir? I'm sorry? 21:40. Would you confirm, sir, 21:40 by the gentleman's watch? Yes? 21 minutes. 21:40. 9:40. Yes, the Irish. Which hand do you write with, sir?
Left hand.
I'm going to ask you to hold it in your left hand. It's essential nobody touches any working part. And just close your hand on it, if you will, and just hold it there. Sir, what is the story on this?
The same, 21:40.
And how long have you had this, sir?
About 10 years.
And does it keep good time?
Yes.
Fine. Up until tonight. Sir, I'm going to ask you to hold it in the palm of your hand. I want you to keep it warm, and don't open your palm. Just keep it in a gentle pressure, if you will. What is the story of I haven't seen the 8,000. It's broken. What is your name, sweetheart? Sally. That's you. What time is it, Sally, by me?
That was where he's beginning himself.
What? 9:37. And was this watch working when you brought it up, Sally? How long have you had it, did you say? How do you know if a watch is working? It doesn't go tick, tick. How do you know if it's working, Sally? The second hand goes around. Sir, is that watch working in your humble estimation?
If the glass is tiny and have a feel.
Robert, you better come over here now.
It's not working. Sir, is that watching?
I'm watching.
You're quite sure. Yeah. That's what Nick is. That one stopped. It has stopped.
sir, would you say if that's working?
It was working.
It's not working?
No.
It's not working? Is that watch working, sir?
No.
That watch isn't working. Sir, is that watch working? It is not working. Sir, the report is that your watch is not working. Contrary to popular belief, at 12 minutes to 10, it stopped. Which hand do you write with?
Right.
You're not responsible for times, are you? Schedules are in the book. Yours truly, Peter J. Shields. Until we meet again, thank you.
dog.
Second hole, as tight as you can get it.
That's it.
Good? All right. David, what we're going to do now, a little challenge. Are you open for a challenge?
You are.
All right. You look like a sporting man. I'll tell you what you're going to do. There's a beat you in.
Yeah.
Is that a good arrangement? All right. Would you like to have another check, David? This time, make sure there are no picking devices concealed in my sleeve, behind my watch.
I'm not going to play the way, Mark.
All right. Okay, are you ready for this, David? Julie will take the microphone, you grab the rope. Off we go, when you're ready.
Ready?
Yes,
see, go.
Go. Yeah, go. Come around this side, David, they can't see you. That's good. No, David, round here, the cameraman. Give David a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. You get the console's 22 rifle and fire this bullet directly, ladies and gentlemen, into my mouth. And I will attempt to catch the bullet between the teeth. Over 12 people have died presenting this illusion since it was first introduced in the world and bringing this message to young people wherever they appear in our audience. Young people, guns and firearms are best play with or tamper with firearms. Only recently, a young girl about 7 years of age was fatally wounded because her father never, ever played with firearms. And for you bigger children in our audience, let me say this. Except the presentation, what you are about to witness is impossible. Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment, the death-defying bullet catch. The bullet that you see, ladies and gentlemen, is normally referred to powder from this bullet. And the trick, of course, is the correct removal of the right amount of powder. And if I take too much powder out of that bullet, it won't even reach me. If, on the other hand, I've left too much in, it will be coming far too rapidly for me to do anything about, as indeed happened on June 13th last year when I narrowly lost an eye. Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment, the bullet match.
Sir, the bullet to the reach?
Ladies and gentlemen, the gloves you see me putting on are designed to protect my eyes and throat at the time that Cherie fires a bullet. Now, I will be giving Cherie three commands. First, to ascertain. Okay, let's go. Oh, hang on, there's one thing I haven't done.
There's a dog, yeah.
Okay, here we go then. You've got that balloon there. What is your name? I want you to put your hand on the top or the bottom of the balloon. We'll buy you a new one so you don't have to worry about it. And I want you to hold it well out in front of you like so, okay? Now I'm going to position you right about here, Pauline. Just for your entertainment, the bullet catch.
Thank you. holding a pillow beneath the head. Don't you know?
She kept me money and